Alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us more power. Give us strength to continue. Zikrullah. Zikrullah. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala sayyidina Muhammad. Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Wa man tabi'ahu bi ihsani li yawmiddin. Wa ala sair al-anbiya wal-mursalin wal-awliya. Wa ibadillahi s-salihin. Wa alayna ma'hum ajma'in. يا أرحم الراحمين ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم دستور يا سيدي يا سلطان الأنبياء دستور يا سيدي يا سلطان الأولياء دستور يا سيدي ومولاي مدد يا رجال الله رجال الله رجال الله أعينونا بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى نحظى بفضل الله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبحان الله إمام الحي الحي the alive the ever living one word destroys all of Christianity one word one name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroys all the foundation that they have put. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Allahu la ilaha illa hu, al-hayyu al-qayyum. They came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Najran. They came, wafd, delegation, came from a place called Najran, to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he's inviting them to accept the truth. And they gave him reasons about Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. We read in Subhanallah, in our Fajr prayer, we read Surah Al-Ma'idah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking Sayyidina Isa ibn Maryam, A'anta? Is it you? Imagine if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to you, أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ? Is it you that said? Sometimes when the lawyer tells you, is it you that said? You go, oh, what's happening now? أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ? Is it you that have said to the people, oh, Isa? Ya Isa ibn Maryam, أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ? Is it you that have said to people, take me and my mother as gods? Because they came and they said, you know, Isa alayhi salam is the son of God. Sometimes they say he is God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Surah Ali Imran, the first almost 80 verses. The first almost 80 verses of Surah Ali Imran, chapter 3, is all response to this delegation that came that was Christian to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started Alif Lam Mim. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam knows what that means, and Awliyaullah. But we continue. Allahu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, la ilaha illa hu. There is no God except Him, Al-Hayy. One word, the alive one, the ever-living one. God, a God never dies. There's no way a God can die. If a God dies, who is managing His kingdom? Who is taking care of His servants, of His creation? How, if a God dies, then ever-living is obsolete. Either a God is alive, always, ever living. Or if he dies, then he is never ever living. That means death can happen again. One word. They say Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sins. Died. If Jesus Christ is a God, God does not die. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says God is ever living. Al-Hayy. الحي سبحان الله العلي العظيم. One word, Sheikh. You don't need to debate anything else anymore. It's finished. Subhanallah, that came. One word, Allah la ilaha illa hu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no God except Him, the ever living. Never one moment of death happens to God, to a God, to the God, to God. Never ever, not even death, sleep. Not even sleep, sinatun. The sign of sleep, as all of us have today. Everyone is going like, snoozing, right? Snoozing. Not even snoozing occurs to God, let alone sleep, let alone death. One word, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. Because Mawlana Sheikh Nazim is talking, subhanAllah, I opened this. This is after what we talked yesterday about تنزل لتقبيل يد, to bring somebody, oneself down, to humble somebody, or himself down, to kiss the hand of other. After that, subhanAllah, Allah, Mawlana Sheikh Nazim is talking about Sayyidina Abu Ahmad al-Sughuri, one of the grand sheikhs. One of the grand sheikhs. He said that Sayyidina Abu Ahmad al-Sughuri is talking about Hagia Sophia. Hagia Sophia, they call it. Hagia Sophia in Istanbul. It was the church, the temple, the place where coronation took place. The coronation of the Byzantine emperors. They took place there. And if you visited Hagia Sophia or Hagia Sophia, you would see they had put circles where the emperor stands and the empress and then the people, the royal family, to receive that coronation. So he's saying, Sayyidina Abu Ahmad al-Sughuri is talking about that Hagia Sophia, that church. That was a masjid, but first was built as a church, Grand Sheikh is saying. And he's saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this was His will to speak this hadith. And whatever we receive from grand sheikhs, from our shuyukh, we believe. Mawlana Sheikh Nazim said that awliyaullah, when they hear a hadith, they see the light that is accompanying the hadith. That is their confirmation that the hadith is true. They don't need the chain, or who narrated it, or in which book it was mentioned, or which imam mentioned it. They see the nur of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the knowledge, the divine light with that hadith moving. If they see that, they don't look at anything else. This is it, sahih. This is a true hadith. So he said, they were trying to build this Hagia Sophia as one of the alam, the marker. The marker for the church of the east. Vatican was the west. This one was the church of the east. But every time they tried to build the dome, because it was huge, it's a huge dome, it will break. It will crack. They could never fix it. Mawlana Sheikh Nazim is saying, until they heard that Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam came in Arabia, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent a letter to their emperor. So they heard that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam appeared in Saudi Arabia. For some reason, Grand Sheikh is saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired that architect an idea. He says, go to that Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If he's a true one, he will tell you how to build the dome. He says, استأذن من القيصر. He asked his Caesar permission. He said, أريد أن أذهب عنده. I want to go to see this one. فإن كان صحيح النبي لابد أن يكون عنده شيء لأجل القبة حتى تتماسك.
If he is truly a Nabi, then he should have something for this dome to become perfect.
Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's name is Mukammil. The other day we were talking about Wasilun, Mawsulun, the one that has reached, the one that is connected, and the one that connects. And one of his names is Kamilun, Mukammil. Perfect, and the one that perfects. So he said, I will go. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired from the reality of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that he perfects. He said, I will go and see if he has something to perfect this dome. So he said, he moved from Constantinople, this architect, and he reached Medina al-Munawwara. Ala sakiniha afdalu salati wa salam wa ala alihi wa ashabi ajma'in.
When he arrived, he came in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, from where you're coming? He said, I am coming from Constantinople. I am an architect and I am building the biggest church in the East. But I have one problem. Whenever I build the dome, it does not hold, because their belief is cracked. Al-Hayy, the alive, ever living. So he says, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam picked some ramal, sand, tafal. He put from his holy saliva in it. He said, "Dahu fi khaltat al-bina yatamasak." He said, "Take this sand with my saliva, put it in the mix of the bina, of the building, in the mix of the cement and everything, like you do, Imam, in your spare time. That's your hobby." And it will hold. It will tatamasak. It will hold itself. That is the holy saliva of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this guy, this man, he took the sand and he looked. And Mawlana Sheikh Nazim said that he is Sayyidina Abu Ahmad al-Sughuri, Grand Sheikh, is relating this story about Grand Sheikh. So one of our Grand Sheikhs, he said, in himself, he said, what is this? I came all the way from Constantinople to the desert, to Medina Munawwara, to ask if he has ilm, if he has knowledge that he teaches us how to establish the perfection of this dome. And all he gave me is this sand with his saliva in it. إذا كان عنده علم يعلمنا لكنه أعطانا هذا الشيء. We were coming here to see if he has knowledge that he can teach us, but he has given us this. What is this? So he went back until he reached a place close to Istanbul, and he was very, very thirsty. مولانا الشيخ نازم saying that he was thirsty. There is secrets in here. It is a story, but there's always that wheel. There's always a hidden, unknown knowledge in stories. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's holy saliva, he is asking for knowledge, this architect. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's holy saliva, when he put it in the mouth of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he became an ocean of knowledge. So when he put the saliva in that holy sand, he was putting his knowledge. That means your church will only be perfect with my knowledge.
Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayhi. Ya Sayyidi.
He didn't understand. He just saw saliva. But the saliva meant knowledge. His holy knowledge, his holy words, what he has uttered from Holy Quran and Sunnah, he did it with his mouth.
بِلِسَانٍ عَرَبِيٍّ مُبِينٍ بِلِسَانٍ
we have revealed Quran in a clear Arabic tongue. Tongue is coated with saliva. So your church will only hold with my knowledge. Your religion can only hold, can only become true, can only taqum, rises, stands, establishes itself with the knowledge of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this man went back to Istanbul, walking to Constantinople, walking. He was almost there, but he reached a place that he became very, very thirsty. وصل لمكان عطش بحكمة الله عطشا شديدا. He became very thirsty. When he came to the well, he found a well. He came to his heart that I am carrying this sand mixed with the holy saliva of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the well is very deep. He said, "Let me see if there is a secret in this sand. It will be clear." So he took few grains from it, ورماها في البئر, and he threw it. تفلفل في البئر. How does it go? Sheikh Ali Sayyid is not here. You should come, Sheikh Ali. Where are you? You only live 5 minutes away. What is it? تفلفل في البئر. He threw his holy saliva in the يا قمرون. Everybody recites قمرون, but you have to pay attention to the meanings. He threw, or he put some of his holy saliva in that well, and it became a spring of water. So this guy is repeating the same thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired his heart. He threw the holy saliva of Rasulullah, some of it, some of that grain, in the bi'r, and the bi'r, and the well, وطاف البئر. The well became a spring. So the guy was drinking, but the flowing of the well did not stop. Grand Sheikh is saying the well overflooded and started to move as a flood after him. أخذ يهرب والماء يضرب على أعقابه. He is running and the water is chasing him. والماء يفيض وراءه خاف وصعد للجبل. The water is coming, rushing on him. That's the knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His knowledge, there's no end. He ran up to the mountain, and the water flooded the whole land that he was in, and there was a big lake in that country. He said, until now you see a whole balad, a whole land with the towers of its churches, because this was Christian back then, flooded with the water that came from that well that had the holy saliva of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That knowledge covers, knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will cover all that churches. He escaped and he came to Constantinople. Look, Mawlana Sheikh Nazim is telling a story, but that story has such deep meanings. قالوا أتى المعماري. Everybody was so happy. Oh, the architect came. At last our church will be built correctly. So the Malik and Wuzara and Umara, the king, the ministers, the princes, everybody gathered and the people gathered and said, what news do you have? Can we build our church? Grand Sheikh is saying, هو عرف هذا السر. He understood the secret. ولكن لينسب لنفسه الفضل. But he wanted to attribute the fadl, the power or the miracle or the favor or the knowledge to himself. That is the ego. The ego is what? Now I'm going to show them that I know and I can do and I know everything. لينسب لنفسه. He wanted to make his ego the one that is shown. So with the knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what did this one do? He said that knowledge is not from him, that is from me. How many shuyukh nowadays they say, they take the knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whatever they understood from it, and they attribute it to themselves, to show themselves. So Grand Sheikh is saying, this man came and he said, "At'abtu nafsi," I just made myself tired. And he took what Rasulullah ﷺ has given him and he put it in the mix of the building. He said, "I will build it. I know how to do it. Let's do it." So they built it from scratch and this time it held. So he showed people that he knew how to make it. He didn't say that Rasulullah ﷺ gave me that knowledge. He didn't say that Rasulullah ﷺ supported me with his holy knowledge. Nowadays, so many people, they go online and they speak of what? Of the knowledge that Rasulullah ﷺ has brought. And what do? They attribute it to themselves. They attribute it to themselves. So that dome is still there in Hagia Sophia. And when the hour comes, when Qiyamah comes, Grand Sheikh is saying, the same way as the cover of the pot, when it falls, it rolls on the ground, that Qubba, that dome, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is destroying earth to build the new earth for Qiyamah, that dome will not be destroyed, rather it will fall on the ground and then roll. Because of the power of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in it. So he says, "As-sahaba al-kiram ta'ajjabu." Sahaba al-kiram, radiyallahu anhum, may Allah be pleased with them, they were surprised. A man came to build a church. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him something to hold the dome. They were surprised, but this is the mu'jizah, this is the miracle of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is saying, "Latuftahanna al-Qustantiniyya." Constantinople will be open. And that church that they are building, it will be a masjid. So he gave that power for that church to be built, for it to become a masjid. Grand Sheikh is saying that's why Sahib al-Zaman goes to Istanbul, to Constantinople. That church became a masjid, then now it's a museum, but it's going to become back a masjid. Sahib al-Zaman, when he takes the amanat, which is in the building behind the masjid, that the palace behind the Hagia Sophia, behind the masjid, he will take the sacred trusts, and him and his khulafa, his deputies and his wuzara and his ministers will pray in that masjid. And that masjid, that church, Sayyidina Ali radiallahu an has turned it to Qibla. He said, in that church, the Qibla was corrected by Sayyidina Ali, and if you go in there, you could see the finger of Sayyidina Ali that has rotated that church to where? To Qibla. Sayyidina Ali is involved. Sayyidina al-Mahdi is involved. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is involved. The divine knowledge is involved. In what? In a church. Why? What is worshipped in a church? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God, plus others. O Muslim, O mu'min, O human being, your heart is a church. Your heart is a church. Your heart has to be a masjid. In your heart you have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but there are others in your heart. Mawlana Sheikh Nazim is giving you a story to indicate to you a secret in your heart, that you have turned your heart into a church. You pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you worship others. And the one you worship in there is your ego, And you tell your ego tells you, أنا ربكم الأعلى. I am your Lord. Your ego tells you that. And who's going to correct that? Who is going to correct that is Sayyidina al-Imam Sahib al-Zaman. He will turn your heart from a church to a masjid. And Sayyidina Ali will correct your qibla. Your qibla is for dunya. Your direction is dunya. You ask for dunya. You teach people the knowledge of the books to gain dunya. Sayyidina Ali will correct your qibla. These are all secrets in that story. That for your heart to become a pure heart directed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sayyidina Ali radiallahu an has to put his finger in there. Sayyidina Imam al-Mahdi has to take the sacred trusts and turn your church that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and others are worshipped in into a masjid that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is worshipped. That is tawheed. They speak about tawheed. A grand sheikhs, they teach that better than you teach it. And only your church will become a masjid and it will hold its dome with the holy knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yeah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the ones that reach Sahib al-Zaman. That corrects their hearts to become a masjid to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والطائفين والعاكفين والركع السجود. The ones that make tawaf and the ones that make i'tikaf, where? In the masjid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the ones that make tawaf in Masjid al-Haram, Makkah al-Mukarrama, and the ones that make i'tikaf and they make ruku', they pray. They say the real ones, the real ta'if, the real one that makes the tawaf is al-anwarul ilahiyya, the divine lights. Wal-aakifin, the ones that are always there is al-ma'arifur rabbaniyya, the divine knowledge. If you can't turn your heart into a mahbat, what is a mahbat? A landing strip, like they have the planes. If you can make your heart a landing area for the divine lights and for the divine knowledge, then you have turned your heart into a real masjid. That was Sayyidina al-Imam al-Mahdi Sahib al-Zaman does to your heart, oh human being. And your heart is corrected to its qibla by Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu with the knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then you will have perfect structure of a masjid. He said, "Dalika mashhadun azim." Allah subhanahu, Grand Sheikh is saying, that is a wonderful, majestic scene. Because now you are seeing the divine lights in your heart. You sit as awliyaullah they do. They are witnessing, beholding divine lights, and they are receiving divine knowledge. From whom? From Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. He is with you wherever you are. رَزَقَنَ اللَّهُ وَإِيَّاكُمْ هَذَا الْمَشْهَدِ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all that scene. Inshallah. So be careful. Don't put others besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't ask for dunya and put it in your heart. Don't ask for your ego to become big and put it in your heart. Don't make your heart a church where three is worshipped. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we worship. And then you worship dunya and you worship nafs. Be careful, O Muslim, O mu'min. These are the teachings of tariqah. These are the teachings of Naqshbandiyya. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the ones that reach real tawheed. Tawheed, la ilaha illallah in the hearts. Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His knowledge will correct. His knowledge will give power to that masjid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. Wa min Allahi at-tawfiq bi hurmat al-habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa bi sirri surat al-fatiha. Alhamdulillah. MashaAllah. Al-hayy.